Hi. Here we have an Acer Aspire laptop that need to be replaced with the keyboard. As you can see, this is one of the types. You see the plastic, the upper plastic cover is on the keyboard. Actually, the keyboard is below the plastic cover. Here we can. We have a new keyboard. As you can see, there is a places between the buttons that comes here. So this is a bit tricky operation. That's why we're gonna record it. How we gonna do? So we begin. And disassemble the laptop, remove the old keyboard and place the new keyboard. So this is a tool you need, X screwdriver, flat screwdriver, guitar player 4, unzipping the plastic. And probably a soldering iron. You're gonna see why it's that. So we're removing all the bolts from underneath. As I can see. All are the same length. This one is holding the optical drive. You can remove it. So the soldering iron probably is gonna be needed. So the old keyboard is actually melted on the plastic on the upper cover, so probably we're gonna need, there is two options to set a new keyboard, to melt the old. So all the bolts from the bottom are removed. Now we're going to use the guitar player tool to easily, without scratching, remove the upper cover. So we need to be careful with the upper cover. Under the upper cover there are thread cables for the keyboard and the touchpad. So this one from the keyboard is a little bit tricky. There is one that needs to be pushed back so it cable can be released. So as you can see, there's some dust here that need to be cleaned. So we're gonna place this side. Now here are the spots. As you can see, here are the spots, that plastic spots that holds the keyboard in place. So these need to be removed. We usually cut them with a scalpel. Release the keyboard, and after that, with the soldering iron, melting the plastics and mount the new keyboard in place. So now we're gonna do this here. So I tried with these two scalpels, but doesn't seem to be working fine. This was easy with former models of Acer, but this model, I tried this trick with 3 millimeter, 3.5 millimeter. It seems to be working. We're gonna see if the mounting was gonna be right, because we are removing now more from the plastics. So maybe we, after the removing the old keyboard, replacing the new keyboard, maybe we're gonna use glue, because we are removing more from the plastic material now. So this way, oops, need to be careful. Remove. So we're doing okay so far. Let me see. So now we gonna need to remove these stickers. There's one more here on the sticker. This is the procedure. We're gonna cut the video here and proceed after the all these are completed. So we're completing with removing all the plastics that are holding this cover on the keyboard. So we're gonna need to clean all of this and the keyboard is now removed. As you can see, there has been all kind of liquids and stuffs in here, so we're gonna need to clean all of this. Set this in here. Clean all this. clean the dust on the fan and get back when all this gonna be clean. So we have cleaned everything, now everything is clean up. Now we need to place the new keyboard on the place. So we do it like this. We press all the joints because there are some places that seems fine. So now this goes over the keyboard. This is the way. So now we're gonna use, as we talked before, we're gonna use our soldering iron to melt the plastic that will hold in place the new keyboard. And this is the way how we're gonna do it. So we use this for cleaning, so we not damage the point needle for our soldering iron. So we press the plastic, we melt the plastic and try to apply it some parts of the plastic to be on top of the metal, so that will hold in place. Also on the places that are broken up, a lot of the plastic is broken, that doesn't have what to hold the metal, we're gonna apply some glue. Sorry. And this is how we're gonna do for all this. Sort of these places. So I'm gonna leave this aside. I'm gonna clean it up here. Let me see. As you can see, these joints holding in place. But anyway, we're gonna apply some glue on the weak spots. So we after to finish this, we continue the video. So we complete the assembly of the bottom part. We used some hot glue here on the bottom spots and some glue, secondary glue on the side parts. So now this part looks like new. It's very solid. So now I need to assemble the laptop and we're good to go. So nothing, we don't touch nothing from here, so everything is assembled, everything seems fine. So just we need to place this part, connect the flat cables. They are a little bit tricky to do so. So let me show what I'm gonna do. So first I'm gonna connect the touchpad because it's longer. This is so tricky. There we go. Just to open the bottom plastic, place the cable, flip cable inside and squeeze it. So I first like to, before mounting all the bolts, I want to turn on the laptop because everything is connected. I'm gonna leave it the optical disk drive. I'm gonna turn on the laptop and see if all the buttons are working. And after that, I'm gonna complete the procedure. Closing the laptop. There we go. I'm gonna enter the BIOS here. It was too fast. It's already begun. This was the keyboard. Due to video privacy, I'm gonna lean the windows, lean the display so not see any files or pictures. There's a picture on the background. So now I'm gonna open new text document. I'm gonna test tonight. Backspace, enter, tap. Still Windows loading. It's not a SSD drive, it's hard drive, so it's loading a little bit slowly. Caps lock. So far so good. Let's see if it function keys work. Yes, yeah. Windows button. Space. So seems all the keys are working, so I'm gonna end up the video here. So only need to mount the optical drive, bolt all this together, and this is it. So I hope this will help you mount your keyboard. There's plenty of this type of keyboards. Usually this is not my favorite type. So thanks for watching.